Don Caspar came. And Don Caspar was an American working, and he was the only American working on the viruses and by X-ray analysis. And he had moved into tobacco mosaic virus. And around about 56, he published a one-dimensional map of tobacco mosaic virus. And Rosalind, he never would publish it, but Rosalind wrote his paper totally from beginning to end, so she could publish her own paper on the nucleic acid-free virus.
Yes.
But what we had done, I have to go forward a bit, or back a bit. We had started to work on spherical viruses. This is because the Bernal had started this again, as usual, in the late 1930s. And they'd shown you could crystallize various plant viruses. Again, Boardman and Perie had done this. This is the same Perie. These were, of course, very large crystals, very large unicell crystals. The unicell of Turnip Yellow Mosaic Virus was 700 angstroms. And Rosalind thought that I ought to move on to another subject for me to be distinct from her. So she suggested that I take up spherical viruses. And so that's when you, John Finch, came to work with me on spherical virus, and Ken Holmes worked on TMV. That, I've forgotten what year that was, but it must have been 56. About 56 or 57. You arrived in 55. Yes. 55 you arrived. Yeah. So the and so with spherical viruses, of course, Don Caspar had got some tomato bushy stunt virus. I've forgotten where he got it from, but he published the first paper showing that evidence for icosahedral fivefold symmetry in tomato bushy stunt virus. And I went on with John. And I remember we had a much larger unit cell. I remember we had to redesign the collimators and
yes.
It was quite a feat to get a decent picture. And we got pictures of Turnip Yellow Mosaic Virus, which showed that they also had icosahedral symmetry. And so this was the beginning.
Jim and Francis had put out a paper.
In 56.
Yeah.
Yes, Jim Watson, Francis Cricket published a paper in 1956 at a symposium, a SIBA symposium on the nature of viruses. And this was, what they argued was that if spherical viruses had to be built out of a lot of different subunits on the model of tobacco mosaic virus, then the packing they'd have to adopt to give you a sphere, you'd have to follow one of the point group patterns, either to have tetrahedral, octahedral, or icosahedral symmetry. So they'd expect, but they didn't say any more beyond that. Well, it turned out that these viruses all had icosahedral symmetry. And then later, when we did polio, that was 1959, polio virus also had icosahedral symmetry and built on the same principles. The polio work was quite psychologically important because people used to think that the virologists thought that all animal viruses were DNA and all plant viruses were RNA. And here was polio virus, which is an RNA virus, an animal virus, and moreover, it has the same kind of construction architecture as a plant virus. And people began to see that these were false distinctions. So the work was of some general importance, apart from the interest in the structures, in sort of educating the virologists.